Hey guys, and welcome into the Raxi Report. Okay, so today I'm doing something a little bit different. I am doing what is on my phone, or what's on my Galaxy, or what's on my iPhone, although it's not an iPhone. This is a new kind of video idea, because I've seen loads of different people do this, and I want to show you what my day-to-day kind of routine is on my mobile. So here you go. This is Samsung Galaxy S6 in gold, and I'm going to show you what I go on my phone. Okay, so there will be videos coming back to normal. It's just I'm not really been feeling the YouTube mood recently, so I'll be coming back to do more videos soon. But right now I just wanted to kind of just go through and show you some awesome different stuff. So you can see I've got different folders. My games folder, you can probably tell what kind of gamer I am. I absolutely love the Grand Theft Auto series, of course Vice City. Futurama is really good fun. That's a really, really good game. We've also got Dead Effect 2, which is great. Carmageddon, one of the best Android games, which is ridiculous. Oh, I've just unlocked a new chest in Clash Royale, which is a new game that's just come out. I've got Jetpack Joyride, Blossom Flashsack, which is a pain in my butt and I hate it, but I love it as well. It's amazing. This game is fantastic when it works and it doesn't need your money, because the game is a very kind of hard for no apparent reason. You can go through and be absolutely brilliant and then get absolutely wrecked by one level. So here we go, we're just going to jump straight in. I love this game. It's beautiful, it's colorful, it's amazing, but I'm playing this with a mouse, which is quite weird. So what I have to try and do on this level, this is like level 30 something, I have to try and get all of these buds to blow up, and so I have to get all four. So what I normally do is you'd have to get the certain color into the certain bud, and I'm not very good at this level, and you only get 13 goes to do it in, so it's a bit of a pain in the butt. I would recommend getting this game, but only for playing the first like world. After that it gets slightly ridiculous, so I'm gonna do that and that explodes. Boom. I just love the colors and the noises, and I'm very visually and sound led in my mind. So it kind of, it makes me feel all happy inside. This game is amazing. But yeah, it kind of sucks when you absolutely fail at it, like I have been. So there's that. Okay, we're going to jump back to the home. Alright, so I've been playing a lot of that. If you guys know how to get through that level, send me a message. Although, you can buy extra gems or whatever to continue your life, because you, when you get to the end of your lives, it's like, do you want to spend 13 gold bars to continue playing? And it's like, no, I can't, because I'm not spending 79p when I'm not guaranteed that I'm actually going to win anything. So, you know. Microtransactions, that's a whole different story. Jetpack Joyride, a really, really fun game. Spider-Man 2 is insane. It's amazing, and I don't know if I'm going to be able to show it off. We can try. We can try this. Here we go. I'm not sure if this is going to work. Oh, look at this. Oh my god, this game is amazing. If you're looking for a console-style fix, this is fantastic. It's really, really, really good fun. I'm not sure how I'm going to go about playing it with a mouse and a keyboard, but we can see. Oh my god, I hate my life. Okay, all right. So jump into this. I just want to stand there literally and just show you how good it looks, and then we'll come out of it. I just want to show you this. Okay, are you ready? This game looks incredible. This is running on a mobile phone at about 60 frames a second most of the time, pretty much all the time, because it's a Galaxy S6, which is like a mega computer in phone aspect. Yeah, it's incredible. There's missions, there's different things you can attack and take down, there's bad guys you can attack, and it's just insane. It's a completely explorable world, which is amazing. The game actually runs really well with a touchscreen. I don't normally like touch screen games, but this one is absolutely fantastic and I absolutely love it. See, there's someone down there that needs my help. I need a doctor, please help, and I'm just flying away. Goodbye, sir. Goodbye. Oh my god, so we'll come out of that. I'm the meanest. Okay, so we're gonna close these apps because otherwise they're going to slow down everything that I'm doing. So if we go to close all, there you go. All right, so the last game I'm gonna show you quickly is Clash Royale. It's literally just come out. It's made by the same people that did Clash of Clans, so if you're a fan of Clash and Clans, I've played quite a bit of Clash of Clans. It's just I've never really gotten into it like a lot of people have. So you've got your usual kind of wait 15 seconds for items and cards. You can upgrade your characters. We're going to jump straight quickly into a battle here and just show you. It's a cool idea. So you have a certain amount of energy counting up here, and these guys cost a certain amount. So I can they're like cards. You can throw them out on the battlefield. So I could throw out the big guy here. And all I have to do is destroy these three bases. By destroying the king, I'll destroy all of the other two. And as you can see there, they spawn minions to try and attack me. It's kind of like a MOBA, I suppose. There's two lanes, and you have to try and defeat the other person's base. I don't usually play MOBAs, so I'm not too up on skill with it, but this is actually quite fun. And there's a fully online kind of battle mode, which is quite insane. We're going to try and save up for the next couple of players. Let's see if we can take this guy down. Let's use this. Okay, bomber. Oh no. But yeah, I've seen a lot of channels do app gameplay and kind of just play Clash of Clans. So if you guys want to see Clash of whatever this is. Clash of Castles or something, I don't know. It's Clash of Clans-ish. It's the same meet people. It's the same kind of game. So let's throw the archers out. See, we aren't getting our asses kicked. I just need to get one of these guys. I'm gonna wait until I'm fifth. Come on, hurry up. Actually, you know what? We're gonna throw out the bomber, because the bomber is extremely useful, because he can throw his little bomb onto this base here. Look at this little guy. You really so cute. Right, so we're going to drop the giant, because that base has slightly less health. Because these guys are just tanks that'll annihilate anything. So let's just pull out the knight so he can go off and attack these guys. He's normally better against human, or no, like little skeletons or goblins. But he's okay against bases. We can also just help out by throwing in some arrows. We can hit two bases at once with those. And let's pull out this little guy, the bomber, because the bomber is extremely useful. And some archers. Oh my god, we're getting our base being annihilated. Thankfully, we've got our little guy helping us out. Let's fire a fireball just to take down his health a little bit. We've got 46 seconds left to try and take down the boss's base. This isn't looking good on our part. This is still the training. I suck at all video games. Okay, keep throwing. Fire arrows. Arrows away. Okay, come on, go. Just send the tank in. Fire everything! Oh my god, just you need you, get in there, not enough elixir, come on, hurry up! I've got 16 seconds! I'm not gonna do it in time. Oh, I got one of the bases, that's alright, I got one star. Come on! Oh, we're so close! 3 seconds! No, one! Ah, no! Okay, so yeah, that is... That's this game. Oh, I got a wooden chest anyway. Okay, so what we're going to do is we're going to go back to the home. Okay, so that is Clash Royale. Right, in terms of other apps I use daily, of course, Twitter is amazing. Twitter is beautiful and brilliant, and I love everyone on Twitter. So go follow me. Go follow my amazing Twitter feed. I am at Roxy Report. You can go follow me there. As you guys can see, there I am. Hello. So that's Twitter. I use that a lot. If you're a fan of Twitter, then hooray. I use Facebook alone. I'm not going to share that because it has people's names and stuff on. I don't really want to do that. YouTube, of course, is a main factor of my life. Music, of course, I listen to a lot of music. That's what my phone is usually surrounding. Podcasts, I listen to a lot of different podcasts, but right now I'm listening to the Adam Carolla Show and Vault IGN, because I love Fallout, obviously. I got my banking, of course, and my emails, I use that a lot. Of course, gallery. Camera's not on here because thankfully with the S6, you can just double tap the main home button and it'll do that for you. In terms of everything else, Zed and speed test are like my kind of go-to random apps. I love doing speed tests, and to find out that my 4G internet connection is faster than my home's internet is slightly disappointing. Got Microsoft apps, these came with a phone. In terms of my selfie app, I actually call the folder selfie, hashtag selfie. Instagram, Facetune, and camera are my go-to. They're amazing, that work in unison with each other. I can take a picture with the camera, edit it and cut it and crop it with Facetune, and then put it up on Instagram. That's my magic, I suppose. I love that thing. It's amazing. So I use that, Google, and also I am getting a VR headset tomorrow. So I've downloaded a crap ton of VR games. So I will be doing, if you want, VR headset videos. VR videos with me getting scared in Insidious, or I don't know. I'll find a way of recording it, hopefully, because this can connect via Wi-Fi, not just by USB. But yeah, I'm getting a virtual reality headset tomorrow. So VR games, I have a plenty. That is really good, apparently. And so is Just Cause 3 and Roller Coaster VR, of course. But the one I've heard most about is Insidious. War of Words is also really good, apparently, and that's the only game that cost me any money out of all of these. Now this actually allows me to connect to my PC to use my virtual reality headset on my PC games through Steam, which is mind-boggling. So you can play, let's say, Ethan Carter with a virtual reality headset through your phone. Yeah, let's just let that sink in a second. It's mental. Anyway, so that is really it. I hope you guys enjoyed what's on my phone. If you want to see more Clash Royale or virtual reality stuff, leave a comment down below. And I hope you guys enjoyed this. Thanks for watching. But until next time, that's me out. Bye, guys.